Good morning. This is Dr. Adel Bondok, Professor of Anatomy and Neuroscience, Mansoura University, Egypt. Today I will talk about the external features of the brain stem. This is the ventral aspect of the brain stem, and this is the dorsal aspect of the brain stem. Okay? And this is the brain stem, and this cavity is the fourth ventricle. Okay, brain stem, midbrain, upper part, pons, middle part, and the medulla, lower part, and the cavity, this cavity is the fourth ventricle. Okay, so I will talk about the ventral surface and the dorsal surface. Again, this is the brain stem, midbrain, pons, and the medulla. The upper part is the midbrain, the middle part is the pons, and the lower part is the medulla, and this cavity behind the pons in front of the cerebellum is the fourth ventricle. So this is the ventral aspect of the brain stem. What should you know about the ventral aspect of the brain stem? Okay, elevations, like these elevations. Fissures, like these fissures. Okay, and cranial nerves. Regarding the medulla, we have three elevations on each side of the median sulcus, pyramid, olive, and the inferior cerebellar peduncle, connecting the medulla with the cerebellum. Fissures, anterior median sulcus or anterior median fissure, and it is obliterated in the lower part of the medulla by the pyramidal decussation or motor decussation. This pyramid contains a tract. This tract is called the corticospinal tract or pyramidal tract. This corticospinal tract, in the lower part of the medulla, it crosses to the opposite side, decussating the other one to form the pyramidal decussation or the motor decussation. So this is the pyramid. Then the olive is formed by the inferior olivary complex and then inferior cerebellar peduncle. We have three fissures: median sulcus or median fissure, pre-olivary fissure in front of the olive, and the post-olivary fissure behind the olive. The last four cranial nerves exit from the medulla: the glossopharyngeal, vagus, and the cranial accessory exit from the post-olivary fissure. The hypoglossal nerve exit from the pre-olivary fissure. Regarding the pons, in the middle, there is a groove formed by the basilar artery, and this groove is called the basilar groove. We have transverse fibers. These transverse fibers are called the transverse pontine fibers. These transverse pontine fibers collect to form this peduncle, middle cerebellar peduncle. This one, middle cerebellar peduncle. The middle four cranial nerves exit from the pons. Number five, trigeminal nerve. Exit midway between the upper border and the lower border, between the pons and the middle cerebellar peduncle. And this trigeminal nerve is formed by two roots, large sensory root and the small motor root. The sensory root is lateral and the motor root is medial. Okay, then abducens nerve, the sixth cranial nerve, exits between the pyramid and the pons, and then facial and vestibulocochlear nerves exit from cerebellopontine angle. And this is the midbrain. This is the ventral aspect of the midbrain, which is the cerebral peduncle or the cross cerebri. And this is the oculomotor nerve exit from the interpeduncular fossa, medial to the cross cerebri. And this is the trochlear nerve coming from the back of the midbrain. Again, this is the medulla, the pons, and the midbrain. Medulla. Three elevations. The first elevation is the pyramid. Second elevation is the olive. and third elevation is inferior cerebellar peduncle. Fissures, median fissure, pre-olivary fissure, post-olivary fissure. The pyramid contains corticospinal tract. In the lower part of the medulla, the corticospinal tract crosses to the opposite side, decussating with the other one to form the pyramidal decussation or the motor decussation. Then olive and pre-olivary fissure and post-olivary fissure, and then inferior cerebellar peduncle connecting the medulla with the cerebellum. The last four cranial nerves exit from the medulla. The hypoglossal nerve exits from the pre-olivary fissure, the glossopharyngeal, the vagus, and the cranial accessory exit from the post-olivary fissure. This is the pons. In the midline, there is a groove formed by the basilar artery. It's called the basilar groove. Transverse pontine fibers forming middle cerebellar peduncle. The middle four cranial nerves exit from the pons. This is the first one, trigeminal nerve. Trigeminal nerve formed of two roots, medial root, motor root medial, sensory root lateral. The motor root is smaller than the sensory root. Then abducent nerve between the pyramid and the pons, then facial nerve and vestibulocochlear nerve. The facial nerve is formed of two roots, motor root medial and the nervus intermedius or sensory root lateral. Sensory root is called the nervus intermedius because it is located between the motor root and the vestibulocochlear nerve. This is the midbrain, the anterior aspect of the midbrain, and this is the cerebral peduncle or crus cerebri, and the oculomotor nerve exits from the interpeduncular fossa medial to the crus cerebri, and the trochlear nerve is coming from the back of the midbrain. Again, this is the ventral aspect of the brain stem. This is the midbrain, pons, and the medulla. Medulla. Three elevations: pyramid, olive, inferior cerebellar peduncle. Three fissures: median fissure, pre-olivary fissure, post-olivary fissure. This is the pons. Basilar groove, transverse pontine fibers, middle cerebellar peduncle. This is the facial nerve, vestibulocochlear nerve, and the cerebellopontine angle. This is the trigeminal nerve. This is the abducent nerve. And this is the midbrain, crus cerebri, or cerebral peduncle. Again, this is the medulla, this is the pons, and this is the midbrain, cerebral peduncle. This is the medulla, number four is the pyramid, number three is the olive, number five is the inferior cerebellar peduncle. Okay, number two is the basilar groove, number 11 is the middle cerebellar peduncle, number six is abducent nerve. Number nine here, this is the trigeminal nerve, and this is the facial nerve and the vestibulocochlear nerve, and this is the glossopharyngeal nerve. Then we talk about this angle. It's very important, surgically important. This is the cerebellopontine angle. Cerebellopontine angle is located between the cerebellum, pons, and the medulla. It contains very important structures. It contains cranial nerves. The cranial nerves and the cerebellopontine angle are facial nerve, vestibulocochlear nerve, and glossopharyngeal nerve. Number two, this foramen is called the foramen of Loeschke and the lateral recess of the fourth ventricle. We'll see it in another slide. Okay, foramen of Loeschke and the lateral recess, and this is the choroid plexus of the fourth ventricle. Exit from the foramen of Loeschke, and there is an artery crossing the cerebellopontine angle from the basilar artery called ICA, anterior inferior cerebellar artery. Again, cerebellopontine angle contains cranial nerves, facial nerve, vestibulocochlear nerve, and the glossopharyngeal nerve. It contains foramen of Loeschke and the lateral recess, choroid plexus of the fourth ventricle, and ICA. Another photo. This is the cerebellopontine angle. Okay, this is the cerebellobontine angle. It contains the cranial nerves. This is the facial nerve. This is the vestibulocochlear nerve. This is the glossopharyngeal nerve. Look here. This is the facial nerve formed of two roots, motor root and the nervus intermedius. This is the vestibulocochlear nerve formed of vestibular part and cochlear part. This is the glossopharyngeal nerve. Then this is the lateral recess and the foramen of Loschka and the choroid plexus of the fourth ventricle. Lateral recess and this foramen is the foramen of Loschka and this is the choroid plexus of the fourth ventricle coming out from the foramen of Loschka. Cerebellopontine angle. If you look again at these features, this is the basilar groove. These are the transverse pontine fibers, abducens to nerve, trigeminal nerve. This is the midbrain here, and this is the oculomotor nerve coming out from the interpeduncular fossa. Now the midbrain. This is a section of the midbrain, cross section. The midbrain has a cavity, and this cavity of the midbrain is called the aqueduct of Sylvius or cerebral aqueduct. This cerebral aqueduct divides the midbrain into anterior part and the posterior part. This anterior part is called the cerebral peduncle. This one. This is the cerebral peduncle. And the posterior part is called the tectum. This is the tectum. Four colliculi and the trochlear nerve coming from below the inferior colliculus. The cerebral peduncle is formed of three structures. Crest cerebri, most anterior. Substantia nigra in the middle. And the tegmentum is the most posterior part. So the cerebral peduncle, crest cerebri, substantia nigra. Substantia nigra because nerve cells contain melanin pigment. And this is the tegmentum. And this area between the two cerebral peduncles is called the interpeduncular fossa. This is sagittal section. This is the midbrain. Okay? And number four is the cerebral aqueduct. It divides the midbrain into anterior part, which is number five, cerebral peduncle, and the posterior part, number two and number three, which is the tectum. So this is the cerebral peduncle. And this is the tectum. Superior colliculus and the inferior colliculus. Number one is part of the epithalamus, and this is the pineal gland. So this is a sagittal section of the midbrain. Okay, see another cross section. Okay, this is the cerebral peduncle. And this is the tectum, superior colliculus, inferior colliculus. Again, this is a section of the midbrain. And this is the cavity of the midbrain, cerebral aqueduct of Sylvius. It divides the midbrain into anterior part called the cerebral peduncle and the posterior part called the tectum. This is the tectum. And actually, this is the superior colliculus. The cerebral peduncle is formed of three parts. The most anterior part is the crest cerebri. And then this part is substantia nigra. Substantia nigra contains dopamine secreting cells and it is associated with Parkinson's disease. Okay, and this is the tegmentum. Tegmentum contains cranial nerve nuclei and other nuclei like the red nucleus. This is the red nucleus and this is the oculomotor nucleus. This is the oculomotor nucleus and this is the oculomotor nerve coming out from the interpeduncular fossa. And this is the interpeduncular fossa. Okay, this is a cross section of the midbrain. This is the cerebral aqueduct of Sylvius. So the tectum is posterior and the cerebral peduncle is anterior. This cerebral peduncle is divided into three parts. Crest cerebri most anterior. Substantia nigra in the middle. Tegmentum is posterior. This substantia nigra, actually, we'll talk about it later, contains dopamine secreting neurons, from pars compacta of substantia nigra, and these dopamine secreting neurons, if they are affected due to a lesion in substantia nigra, okay, it will lead to Parkinson's disease. So Parkinson's disease is associated with degeneration of substantia nigra. This is the back of the midbrain, which is called the tectum. The tectum is formed of four colliculi called corpora quadrigemina, two superior colliculi and two inferior colliculi. The superior colliculus is a visual reflex center. The inferior colliculus is auditory reflex center. The superior colliculus and the inferior colliculus are connected with the metathalamus. And the metathalamus is formed of the lateral geniculate body and the medial geniculate body. Superior colliculus is connected with the lateral geniculate body by the superior brachium, this one, this arm. The inferior colliculus is connected with the medial geniculate body by this brachium, the inferior brachium. Therefore, the back of the midbrain contains four colliculi, corpora quadrigemina, two superior colliculi, two inferior colliculi. The superior colliculus is connected with the lateral geniculate body by the superior brachium. The inferior colliculus is connected with the medial geniculate body by the inferior brachium. Superior colliculus is visual reflex center. Inferior colliculus is auditory reflex center, and exit of the trochlear nerve below the inferior colliculus. This is the trochlear nerve. Then we talk about the interpeduncular fossa. This fossa, interpeduncular fossa, between the two cerebral peduncles. Okay, you should know the boundaries of the interpeduncular fossa. Boundaries of the interpeduncular fossa. This is anterior boundary, number one, optic chiasma. And this is the posterior boundary, is the upper border of the pons. Okay, on each side, optic tract anterior and the crus cerebri posterior. Again, the boundaries, optic chiasma anterior, pons posterior, on each side, optic tract and the crus cerebri. Then, what are the contents of the interpeduncular fossa? Contents. This is number four, from before backward. This is tuber cinereum, is part of the hypothalamus, and is connected with the pituitary gland by the infundibulum. So number one, tuber cinereum. Number one, I mean here number four, tuber cinereum and the infundibulum of the pituitary gland, and then these buds, mammillary buds, part of the hypothalamus. And then this perforated substance, it's called the posterior perforated substance, because we have another one here outside the interpeduncular fossa called the anterior perforated substance. The posterior perforated substance is perforated by the central branches of the posterior cerebral artery, and then exit of the oculomotor nerve. Again, contents of the interpeduncular fossa, tuber cinereum, mammillary buds, posterior perforated substance, and oculomotor nerve. See another slide of the interpeduncular fossa. This one, boundaries. Okay, anterior, this is the optic chiasma. Posterior, this is the pons. On each side, optic tract anterior, crus cerebri posterior, and the contents, here, tuber cinereum, mammillary buds, posterior perforated substance, and the exit of the oculomotor nerve. So actually, the interpeduncular fossa is the floor of the hypothalamus. Now we talk about the back of the brainstem. This is the back of the medulla, back of the pons, and the back of the midbrain, and this cavity is the fourth ventricle. Okay, so this is the back of the brain stem. Midbrain, pons, and the medulla. Okay, start by the midbrain, here. Four colliculi, two superior colliculi, two inferior colliculi, and the trochlear nerve. Then we talk about the medulla. The medulla is divided into lower part and upper part. The upper part is called the closed medulla because it has central canal. The upper part is called the open medulla because it opens in the fourth ventricle. The lower part of the medulla has two elevations. The medial elevation is called the gracile tubercle and is continuous with the gracile nucleus, with gracile tract. So gracile tubercle contains the gracile nucleus, and this is gracile tract. And then this one is conate tubercle formed by conate nucleus, and this is the conate tract. Okay? Again, the lower part of the medulla, okay, actually three elevations, gracile tubercle, conate tubercle, tuberculum sinuarium formed by the spinal trigeminal nucleus, okay, gracile tubercle or clava formed by the gracile nucleus, conate tubercle formed by the conate nucleus, tuberculum sinuarium formed by the spinal trigeminal nucleus, this is gracile tract, conate tract. Okay, the upper part of the medulla contains sulcus limitans or inferior fovea. It divides the medulla into three trigones. The medial trigone is the hypoglossal trigone, and it is formed by the hypoglossal nucleus. Then the middle trigone is the vagal trigone. This is the middle trigone, which is the vagal trigone, formed by the dorsal motor nucleus of the vagus. And this is the vestibular trigone, formed by the inferior and the medial vestibular nuclei. This angle is called the obex, and this area is called the area posterima, or the vomiting center. This area posterima between the hypoglossal nucleus, between the vagal nucleus or vagal trigone and the gracile tubercle. Between the medulla and the pons, we have these fibers, stria medullaris of the fourth ventricle. Then the pontine part, this is the pontine part, this is the median sulcus, and this is the sulcus limitans. At the upper end of sulcus limitans, this blue area is called the locus ceruleus. It contains the more adrenaline secreting cells. Medial to the sulcus limitans, this is the medial eminence. At the lower end of the medial eminence, there is a facial colliculus. This facial colliculus is formed by the abducens nucleus and the facial nerve fibers. And then this is the vestibular area, formed by two nuclei. The two nuclei are lateral and the superior vestibular nuclei. See another slide. Okay, this is the back of the brainstem. Start by the medulla. The lower part is the closed medulla. The upper part is the open medulla. The lower part contains, this is gracile tubercle, formed by gracile nucleus. And this is gracile tract. This is conate tubercle formed by conate nucleus, and this is conate tract. Okay, gracile tract, conate tract. The upper part of the medulla is the open medulla, contains inferior fovea or sulcus limitans, divides the medullary part of the fourth ventricle into three trigones. This is the hypoglossal trigone. This is the obex, okay? Obex and the area posterior. This is the hypoglossal trigone formed by the hypoglossal nucleus. This is the vagal trigone formed by the dorsal motor nucleus of the vagus. This is the vestibular trigone formed by the inferior and the medial vestibular nuclei. And these fibers are stria medullaris of the fourth ventricle. Here is a pontine part. This is sulcus limitans. medial to the sulcus limitans, medial eminence. In the lower part of the medial eminence, fascial colliculus formed by the abducens nucleus and the fascial nerve fibers. This is locus ceruleus at the upper end of sulcus limitans, contains noradrenaline secreting neurons. This is the vestibular area formed by superior and lateral vestibular nuclei. This is the back of the midbrain, superior colliculus, visual reflex center, inferior colliculus, auditory reflex center, and this is the trochlear nerve. This is the pineal gland, part of the diencephalon. And this is the dentate nucleus of the cerebellum. Now let us talk about the fourth ventricle. This is the fourth ventricle. It is the cavity of the hind brain. It is located behind the pons and the upper part of the medulla, in front of the cerebellum. This is the fourth ventricle. So what should you know about the fourth ventricle? What is the fourth ventricle? It is the cavity of rhombencephalon. It is the cavity of the hind brain. It is located behind the pons and the upper part of the medulla, in front of the cerebellum. Okay. It is rhomboid in shape, diamond. It has four angles. The superior angle is continuous with the cerebral aqueduct. The inferior angle is continuous with the central canal. The lateral angles form lateral recess and the foramina of Lushka. It has lateral boundaries. It has roof and the floor. The lateral boundaries are superior cerebellar peduncle in the upper part, lateral recess in the middle part, inferior cerebellar peduncle in the lower part. The roof is formed of three structures. Okay. Superior medullary velum in the upper part. This superior medullary velum connects the two superior cerebellar peduncles. The lower part is the inferior medullary velum, this one, connecting the two inferior cerebellar peduncles. The middle part is part of the cerebellum. Therefore, the roof of the fourth ventricle, superior medullary velum, part of the cerebellum, inferior medullary velum. The floor of the fourth ventricle is the pons and upper part of the medulla. The fourth ventricle has three foramina. Foramen of Magendie in the inferior medullary velum here in the midline, and the foramina of Lushka in the lateral recess. We'll talk about the communications of the fourth ventricle. It communicates with the third ventricle by the cerebral aqueduct. It communicates with the central canal of the spinal cord. It communicates with the subarachnoid space by foramen of Magendie and the foramina of Lushka. Then we'll talk about the choroid plexus. Okay, this is the floor of the fourth ventricle. The floor of the fourth ventricle is divided by the stria medullaris of the fourth ventricle into upper pontine part and the lower medullary part. The lower medullary part contains three trigones: hypoglossal trigone, vagal trigone, vestibular trigone. The hypoglossal trigone is formed by the hypoglossal nucleus. The vagal trigone is formed by the dorsal motor nucleus of the vagus. The vestibular trigone is formed by the inferior and the medial vestibular nuclei. And this is the obex, and this is the vomiting center area posterima. Okay, hypoglossal trigone, vagal trigone, vestibular trigone, and this is obex. The pontine part, sulcus limitans, at the upper end of sulcus limitans, locus ceruleus, medial to the sulcus limitans, medial eminence, and fascial colliculus, lateral to the sulcus limitans, vestibular area, formed by lateral and superior vestibular nuclei. Okay, medial eminence, facial colliculus, locus ceruleus, vestibular area. This is the lateral recess. This is the lateral recess and the foramina of Lushka. This is the fourth ventricle. We'll talk about the foramina. It has three foramina. This is foramen of Magendie. And these are foramina of Lushka. It communicates with the third ventricle through the aqueduct of Sylvius. It communicates with the central canal of the spinal cord. It communicates with the subarachnoid space by the three foramina. Foramen of Magendie in the inferior medullary velum, this one, and the foramina of Lushka in the lateral recess. And this is the choroid plexus. Now the choroid plexus of the fourth ventricle. Let us talk about the location, the shape, and the arterial supply. This is the choroid plexus. It is attached to the inferior medullary velum. This one attached to the inferior medullary velum. It is T-shaped plexus. It has a stem, and this stem and two arms. This stem is attached to the inferior medullary velum. And the two arms, each arm enters into the lateral recess and protrudes through the foramen of Lushka. And it is supplied by a branch from the pica, branch from the posterior inferior cerebellar artery. This is lateral recess and the foramen of Lushka. And thank you very much. Good luck and best wishes to all of you.